If you're like me, then you probably watch every kind of interesting bit about Adobe Illustrator and try to learn from it. So this morning I watched a video by Dick McClelland who discussed the 10 things he likes most about Adobe Illustrator. And number one is of course the appearance panel. And you can build some very interesting things with it in very interesting ways. And of course, the nice thing about it, it's all editable. And Dick used this shape to show this off, how the appearance panel works. And I think he doesn't use it to the fullest. But let's start at the beginning, because this shape can teach us some nice things about Pathfinder effects and what is very peculiar about them, and what also is the difference between Pathfinder effects and the Pathfinder panel. So let's dive right in. I have prepared the base shape here, and let's first see how Deek made these. So what you of course need is window appearance, and there is the appearance panel. And to get this edgy shape, this star-like shape, you need the zigzag effect. So we're going to effect, distort and transform, and zigzag. And then we reduce the size slightly and add more ridges to this. They need to be, of course, corners, like so. Now, what Illustrator did is apply this to the path. So it's now the complete path that has this effect. So when I add a stroke to this, then you see the stroke has these ridges as well. So I'm going to take away the stroke just that we see this. And you also have seen that the zigzag effect has been applied at the top of this appearance stack. So, like so. So the next thing that Deek did was add an ellipse. I have prepared that as well. So this is a second shape now. We have two shapes. We have the one that has the ridges and the one that has this wide fill. But when you want this to be actually see-through, then you need to punch it. So this is now white, which gives the illusion that you can see through it, but you can't. And in order to actually punch it, we need to subtract it. And when doing this, usually you would go to Window and then Pathfinder, and then you would punch it. But for that to work, you would need to expand the effect, and then you can later change that. So that's what we want to avoid. Now, Pathfinders can also be applied as effects. You find them in the effect menu and there are the Pathfinders. But when just selecting them like you would do with the Pathfinder panel, and then you go to Effect, Pathfinder and Subtract, then you get this warning which tells you, you can apply the Pathfinders to a single object, but it won't make anything. So if I click OK, then what I have actually done is applied the Pathfinder effect to this object and applied it also to that object, and those don't interact. So that's not what we need to do. So select them both and get rid of that. So what we need to do, and what Deek also did, was select these two and then group them like so. And then you have the group. And when you now go to Effect, Pathfinder, Subtract, then you don't see it yet, but let's go into the transparency grid. Then you see you have subtracted it, because in this group there are two shapes, and then Pathfinder effects of course work. The downside of this is that still you have two shapes. And this can be kind of a disadvantage, depending on what exactly you need to edit, because the shapes are still independent of each other, although they are a group. And also, it doesn't actually use the appearance panel too much. You can build this based on one circle. So let's do that. I'm going to push this to the side and let's use this and build on it. So I'm going to ungroup it and then delete this circle. So now we only have this one. Now, in order to build this based on just that circle, what I can do is add another fill. So let's add a new fill to this and make it red. And you already see this also has these ridges because the zigzag effect is applied to the path. It's applied in front of everything else. Now, I don't want the inside of the circle to have these ridges. So what I need to do is get the zigzag effect just into this fill. And you see, the red circle now does not have the ridges. The ridges are just in the black circle. That's nice. That's just what I need. So let's get on. I want to punch the red from the gray one. So select it. And then what we're going to do is go to Effect, Pathfinder, Subtract. We get the warning again, because it's actually just one path. It's okay. And you see, nothing happens because the Pathfinder effect as well is at the top of this. And this is the position where we have just one path and actually nothing can happen. But we have two fills in here. So what if you take this and move this to the bottom? And there you see it actually does something. So let's go to the transparency grid again. And you see it's transparent in the middle. So now when added at the bottom of this, after these two fills came into existence, then the Pathfinder effect actually does something. It still does not quite do what we want because the inner circle is just too large. So how can we solve that? Now, what we could do is try and make this circle here with effect path and offset path and just make it smaller, like so. But you see, nothing happens. So let's click OK. And you see, this obviously has no effect, no effect at all. For whatever reason, this does not work. But what can work is we can take this effect and move it in here. Now nothing happens because we made the circle smaller. So let's go in here again and take away the minus, like so. And you see, there it is. That's nice. It's just too big. So let's make it slightly smaller, like so. And there we have the circle. The circle with the ridges based just on one object and using the appearance panel to the fullest. So that's the stack that we need for that. And let's take a look at something else that I've prepared in here. So this is the complete logo that Deke built, or at least the graphic part of it, the graphical objects, and you can build all of them using just one circle and using all these effects in the appearance panel. You see, there are transform effects and there are also effects that build different shapes. So you can create rectangles from ellipses and other ellipses from ellipses. And then you can transform them using effects. And in order to get holes punched into this kind of stack, so there are different holes. There's a hole in here and then objects and then again holes. In that case, the Pathfinder effects get very, very complicated, if usable at all. And in those cases, you can use knockout groups. And that's what I've done in here. You see the opacity set to 0 and other options. There's the knockout group. So you can build much more complicated shapes using the appearance panel and using just one object. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.